Hello learners, I'm Dr. Sheena Sabarwal and our today's topic of discussion is developing writing skills in lower classes. Before I start with writing skill, let's talk about communication. You know, man being a social animal, we cannot exist in isolation. We need to express our thoughts, ideas and feelings. Sometimes we need to pen down our emotions, our ideas or our thoughts. We want to preserve our ideas for upcoming generations also. For this and for communication, we must have all the four skills, that is listening, speaking, reading and writing. Let's talk about this first listening skill. For listening, we don't need any rigorous practice to acquire, especially our mother tongue or our native language. We learn it as naturally as we are exposed to that environment. Let's take an example of a newly born child or a child who is just 3 or 4 months old. If he listens to any familiar sound, he immediately gives response. Sometimes he giggles, sometimes he smiles. So this is the way the listening skill is naturally developed in a human being. This is again for the speaking skill. For native language or for the language to which we are exposed to, we don't need much practice. We don't need rigorous practice. We acquire speaking skill for our native language from home itself. Daily, a child is exposed to communication among family members and thus he acquires that speaking skill. And speaking skill is also acquired to the environment to which we are exposed. For example, in Jungle Book by Rudyard Kipling, it is a very famous novel. We take an example of Mowgli. He was a human child. Still, he was not able to listen. He was not able to speak. He was not able to read or write any human language because he was exposed to the environment of animals. Then the third skill is reading skill. Yes, for reading skill, practice is very much required. Because we need to have a good vocabulary and we try to speak the words. We will read them in the same manner as we are listening them. Students, that's why in the starting stage, in elementary stage, students are taught phonetic sounds. For example, b, a, t, bat. They are taught the sounds. That's why they develop their reading skill. Writing skill is the last of all the skills, but it is the most important skill. Because writing is a form of communication that allows students to put their feelings and ideas on paper, to organize their knowledge and beliefs into convincing arguments, and to convey meaning through well-constructed text. Good writing skills are essential for effective communication. The better you write, the more easily readers will understand you. Learning to write well takes time and practice. Obviously, we cannot learn writing skill in a day or two. We need to put in very much efforts to develop our writing skills because it is something where we have to pen down our emotions, our thoughts. We don't need any listener for this. It's just one-way communication, but yes, we can preserve our thoughts for upcoming generations through writing skills. What actually we learn from writing skills, yeah, how we can develop our writing skills. First is we are able to write effectively. Second, it is very much enjoyable. Enjoyable in the sense if we don't have any listener, even then we can communicate our feelings, our thoughts. It's just that we take a pen and paper and we are just writing it down what is there in our mind. Then the foundations for writing skill is obviously laid down by the other languages skill. First is listening, speaking, reading and writing. If we are not expert in listening, we cannot speak, we cannot read. And obviously, if we are not getting expert in all the previous skills, we cannot get expert in writing skills. And just now I have told, just we can preserve our ideas for upcoming generations. There are different ways to develop writing skill in elementary classes. First is picture composition, developing stories from the given outline, independent writing, continuing the story, dictation, last letter first, writing own thoughts, and the last one is rhyming words. First one is picture composition. Picture composition is something where a teacher presents a picture to the students and they are asked to write about that picture. They can either describe the picture or they can write a story about that picture or they can give a dialogue writing from that picture. It can also be the series of picture. Series of picture here basically means you are presenting them one picture which is related to the other one, then the second picture is related to the third one, and out of all these three or four pictures, a student is asked to develop either a story or a student is asked to describe all the four pictures in a given sequence. The second is developing stories. Developing stories here basically means wherein a teacher is giving few very important words to the students. For example, here I have taken the example of a thirsty crow story because we are talking about the elementary classes. So we are giving them some few words. Crow, thirsty, water, jungle, pebbles, drank, flew away. It is just that a students have to develop the story from the given outline, or maybe they have to develop the story with the help of words or phrases given to them by the teacher. The main aim of this developing stories is it develops a positive attitude among the students. They can know how they have to join the sentences. This way, they can develop grammatical rules, they know about the conjunctions, they know about wherein they have to put correct word, correct sequence, and how they have to make a proper meaningful sentence. Next one is independent writing. Independent writing is again the most important part of developing the writing skills, because here a child is not forced to write on any given topic. It's just your ideas, your thoughts, and your area of interest. As a teacher, when you talk to the students, there might be some students, they talk about a lot about something. So it is a good technique. You give them that particular topic. Let's say if a child is talking very much about the sports, then that child can be given a topic sports. It is a very good technique that facilitates the learning. And obviously, with this independent writing, strength and weakness of the students can also be known to the teacher. Like, it is very different from other kind of writing skills, because in other kind of writing skills, students are given the topics and they have to express themselves in that particular topic only. But in this independent writing, student is free to think about anything, to think about any topic, and he just need to pen down his thoughts. Next is continuing the story. It is almost similar to that of giving the story outline, which we have already discussed. But here in continuing the story, the words are not given. A complete phrase or at least two or three sentences are given to the students, and then they have to develop the story out of those two or three sentences. And again, it depends upon the teacher. Like, if he is giving the sentence, there is possibility, like, you are giving any particular name to any character of that story. And here the restriction for the students is that they cannot change the character name. They have to follow that name only which is given by the teacher. So in this continuing the story part, the beginning of the story can be told to the students. Then students can be asked to write what they think or what happened or what can happen next in their story. It is considered as the most creative form of developing writing skills, because again, here you can know what a child think, what is his thought process, how he feels, how is his home environment. Because in this type of creative form of writing, at back of the mind, what is there in your mind is naturally comes in your writing skills. It is very important for the students as it develops their thinking process, it develops their imagination, and their imagination can do wonders. We all know, if we talk about this elementary schools, this is something wherein you can make or break the future of students. So in this creative form of writing, it is positive as well as negative, as you can know much more about your students, and obviously you can make your teaching learning process accordingly. Then just now I have discussed, like, state of mind of any child can be known with the help of this thing. Then comes dictation. Dictation is something where a teacher is speaking something and students have to write that particular word. So it is the linking of spoken sounds to their written forms. Teacher can speak aloud, maybe some word or maybe some sentence, and then ask the children to write. This dictation develops listening, speaking, and writing skill at the same time. You don't have to practice separately for these three skills. Listening, how? Listening is developed because you are listening to the teachers. You are listening to their correct pronunciation. Writing is whatever you are writing, you will know exact pronunciation, you will know exact spelling of that particular word. And obviously, with the help of dictation, you can improve your spellings because you are linking the spelling of any word with the sound that is being given by the teacher. Then this is last letter first. Last letter first is something where in the last letter of first word is the first letter of another word. For example, B-A-T, bat. Then other student will start with T, like T-U-B, tub. Then again, third student will start again with B. So what we can do is either we can divide the students in the group as a teacher so that they can have more vocabulary, or we can give this in a form of playway method. With the help of this last letter first, problem areas can be identified. It helps students to increase their vocabulary. And if we are giving them in groups, then it obviously develops the sense of coordination or cooperation among the class students. Then this is writing own thoughts. Any topic of child interest. You can, as a teacher, you can give any topic. They are not forced to write on any particular topic, and it acts as a link between speech and writing, because whatever you are thinking, you are speaking that thing and you are writing that thing in your notebook. Commutative purpose of writing here means you don't need any listener to be with you. You are just commutating yourself. You are penning down your thoughts and you are giving your thoughts a shape. You are giving them a writing shape to your imagination. It gives proper form to your ideas. Whatever is there in your mind, you cannot express your ideas, your feelings to everybody. But yes, if you write your thoughts, then you can convey your message and you are very much relieved. Because if you are under stress or if you are under pressure, and if you are not able to express that stress to anybody, then, and if you will write it down, you will feel very much relieved that yes, I am here to express myself and I have expressed myself. So it develops a sense of achievement and progress in you, because you are very much relieved and you are very much relaxed. Then is rhyming words. Rhyming words is the words that end with the same letters, which give them the same sound. In elementary classes, we are teaching the students phonetic sounds, where they are given last two letters and they are asked to develop more letters from it. For example, we are giving them word IT, and then they have to add a prefix. They have to add one letter. For example, they can develop FIT, fit, BIT, bit, SIT, sit, PIT, pit, HIT, hit. Just with two letters, they can develop their vocabulary of at least 5 to 10 words. So with this rhyming words, maximum words can be learnt in little and in simple practice. It obviously increases the vocabulary of the children. And motor skills are also improved, because here, if you are teaching them, like for example, I have taken this HIT hit, FIT fit. Here you will tell the students, and if students will also speak these words, then they will get to know hit is something to hit. FIT fit is wherein you are fitting in something. Bit, B-I-T, bit is a little bit, a small piece. So this way motor skills are also improved and vocabulary of the students are also increased. So with this, I will end my topic, and I'll just conclude it about this writing skill, that as a teacher, you must promote the students, you must promote all the children of your class to express their own views. If you want, a child should develop, a child should learn writing skill and he should have a good writing skill, then as a teacher, make them free, set them free. Whatever is in their thought, whatever is in their imagination, ask them to write. Don't promote rote learning, never. Because in rote learning, it is just that you are giving them a topic, you are giving them a paragraph, they are just learning it and they are just writing it down. It will never develop a child's creativity, it will never develop child's imagination. So, if we want to develop writing skill, then give positive motivation. If they are committing mistake, no problem, ask them, write it again. We are there with you, we will help you. Again and again, give them positive motivation. And yes, proper time should be given to the students. If as a teacher you are expecting your students that they will develop writing skill in a day or two, just like listening or speaking skill, then you are wrong. You have to give them proper time to develop this writing skill. Because if we want the child should pen down his thoughts, his imagination, so at least you should give him a time at least to think, and whatever he is thinking, he can note it down. And then as a teacher, you should give them proper space to express the ideas. Space here doesn't mean in a classroom you are giving him a space. Space here means no forcing the students. He is writing wrong or he is writing right, correctly. Just motivate him. Instead of scolding him, just try to give a positive reinforcement to the students so that they can develop their writing skills. So with this, I'll conclude my topic, and I hope you must have understood the topic and you must have understood the importance of writing skill, and you must have gathered this knowledge that how we can develop the writing skill among the students. So this, I will end my topic. Thank you so much.